She kept on getting weaker as day dragged into day. The doctors gave no hope for her, she seemed to fade away. My hours were filled with constant dread. Time became a knife that slowly and relentlessly cut the cord of life.
Be inspired on Liberty Radio. Crippling diagnosis, ineffective treatments, relentless chronic pain. Many have lost their will to live as their quality of life has deteriorated. Joy and laughter have been replaced by groans of pain and suffering, leaving them feeling trapped after exhausting all options. However, it is in these moments of despair that the power of faith can shine through, offering a new path to healing and hope. It's time to reclaim your health and conquer every challenge. Every Tuesday, we shall have the Mantle of Miracles services featuring the Corridor of Miracles with 12 disciples. These 12 servants of God will form a corridor and proclaim your healing by faith as you walk through. Join us in the Cathedral of Miracles every Tuesday only at 7:30 p.m. at 232 Seven Sisters Road, Finsbury Park, London, N4 3NX. Invite everyone in need of healing, including yourself, and declare your healing and restoration through faith in God's Word.
Good morning, it's Tuesday and it's just past 7:30 in the morning. Have a wonderful day. Let's live this day together in faith. There is a difference when we live out our day feeling something. How you feel about something that happened yesterday, how you feel about something that is about to happen. But there is a difference in living your day by faith. When you choose to live your day by faith, everything becomes different. A window of opportunity arises. Faith opens doors. And that's what we believe. That's what the Word of God tells us. So if you woke up this morning and you pressed the snooze button 5-10 times and you're struggling, dragging your feet over the, you know, on the floor of your house, listen, we're going to play a testimony in just a moment. While we do that, go in and wash your face. Get ready, because God is with us. And if God is with us, we cannot fail. Whatever you're going through, God gives you today the strength for you to overcome your problems. If you know someone who struggles in the mornings, who struggles with anxiety, who struggles with depression, with motivation, who has been swamped by problems, while we play the testimony, send them a message and tell them, listen, wake up and connect to libertyradio.co.uk now. Send them the link to the app, because when they pray with us, they will receive life. Remember that at the end, we're going to be blessing a glass with water for you to drink and receive strength, receive life. What about you? Do you have something planned special today? Something special happening at work? Something special happening today? Perhaps a plan that's going to perhaps change the course of your life? Let us know what is happening today. We're going to be praying for you at the end of the program. You who have a challenge ahead of you today, let us know in the chat here on libertyradio.co.uk. And at the end of the program, we'll be praying with you. Let's now watch Daniel's testimony. We'll come back in just a few moments to put God's Word in front of our eyes.
Faith helped me to become the person I am today through the practical advice and teachings that I put into practice, from the meetings that I used to go to. This made me the transformed man I am today. So it all started from home. So basically, I came from a broken home. I'm from South London, Brixton. And my parents, they broke up at a very young age. I think I was about maybe 8 or 9. And it had a big impact in my life because I never had a dad around. It's crazy because it was an occasion where I lived in Loughborough with my dad. I moved from living with my mum to living with my dad because my mum was struggling and it was really, really difficult for her. I said in the beginning it was all good, it was fine, and my dad used to take care of us. But my dad got involved with a friend. He called her a friend, but she was more than a friend. And she was addicted to crack cocaine. He said he was going to help her, but instead of him helping her, she helped him. So he became addicted to drugs and things started to spiral. I think that my lowest point was when my brother got ill. We went through a lot. Sometimes my dad would just go away for weeks on end, would be left to cook by ourselves, shopping by ourselves. And it felt like he didn't care. But I know he had his own issues, and that's what it was. With my brother, he had a lot of internal issues that he didn't speak out with. Whereas with me, I would lash out, I would argue, but whereas my brother, he would keep it in. I think that's where the issue started, because he smoked a lot. And with the things that he was smoking, it had an effect on him. And then I just started to see him change. He started to be very, very paranoid. And start to do strange things. He jumped out of the first floor window and he just went into the middle of the street, started trying to steal people's cars. Something that he would never do. We had to contact doctors and he had to get sectioned because they said that he had psychosis. It ended up us having to move out of the area. So in the short period of time, I moved back to my mum's house to stay with her because it wasn't safe for us and we didn't have anywhere to stay. So the guys I used to grow up with now are older. We were in our teens, we were in our 13, 12 years old. There was an older gang in the area which my friend's brothers were a part of. And then we started to be the youngest of that gang. Because I never had a dad as an example, I started to look up to these guys. I got myself involved in drug dealing, fighting, robbing, carrying knives. When I was alone, I felt powerless. I felt angry, I felt disappointed. I felt hatred towards my dad at that point because he put me through situations that I shouldn't have been going through as a young 13, 14 year old. So I was at a special event with a friend and basically we got invited to an event to come to the church where in the beginning, I was reluctant, but when I went home and thought about all the issues and problems that I was going through, and I was by myself in my own thoughts, I said, you know what? I need to go to this place and I need to try and get some help for my brother initially. But when I came, you know, I saw a positive environment, good advice. I met with someone who was working in a youth group that time. He sat me down, he counseled me, he spoke to me. And even though I was off lane to him, all the issues that I was having with my brother, I also realized that I had issues that I had to deal with because he identified them. One main thing was that I couldn't sleep at night. So in the Universal Church, I learned that to make a chain of prayer. So what I would do is I would write my problem down on a card. We call it a chain of prayer card. And I would consistently come to meetings on Wednesdays, on Fridays, and on Sundays, and I would work on those issues. One by one, I started seeing changes. It wasn't easy in the changes because I really had to let go of everything, which was difficult. It took time. It took understanding as well, understanding what to do, why I need to let go, why I need to forgive immediately. I could sleep at night. So when I started seeing them changes, I got a lot more excited. I started to deal with my inner issues, you know, my resentment towards my dad, my anger and outbursts. The Holy Spirit has transformed me. I was a really, really into myself person, selfish, and the Holy Spirit transformed me to be a different man. now I have a passion to help people, especially young people. People I see that have been through the same situation as me. People who have family problems and issues. I have that desire within me to help those to get to the position that I am today. I'm totally transformed in the terms of my mentality, the way that I think, the way I see things, the way I deal with things. I was a very impulsive person, but now I'm not impulsive. I'm rational, I think rationally. Now, you know, being the transformed man I am today, I'm no longer angry with outbursts. I'm in leadership roles in my position. I am the business development manager for an architectural firm. My wife and I have our business where we have a portfolio of properties. I'm working within the church in terms of helping people, guiding people down the right path, counseling people, and making a positive impact in the community, whereas I was a menace to society before.
Did you know that hope can either be positive or negative? We often make wishes for a fresh start and positive change in life. However, deep down, we may have accepted that this might never happen. Wishing is the negative side of hope. Just as you roll a dice, you wish for the number you desire to appear, without any certainty that it will. Conversely, positive hope provides us with the certainty to preserve and believe that our dreams and aspirations will come to reality. Positive hope also shines as a beacon of light, guiding us towards a brighter future. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope. Sunday, 25th August, we will have the Day of Hope, an opportunity to receive this positive hope at 10 a.m. at the Cathedral of Miracles, 232 Seven Sisters Road, Finsbury Park, London, N43NX, or at your nearest Universal Church.
Welcome back. Let's read some messages here. We have some, actually a few people who said they have meetings with their managers today. I'm going to be praying for you later on. Healing of my daughter, someone wrote here. Someone who's revising for, I think, exams. Someone who's about to sign a huge contract. We'll be praying for you as well. Prayer requests for family. We had someone who said, I'm off today. Let me see if I can find it here. It's my day off. So going to the stores for the humanitarian appeal. I imagine that's for the Ukraine. May God bless you. Well, we said that we were going to do this program, Be Inspired in the Morning, from this week, because we believe it's very important to start the day and put God's word in front of our eyes as one of the first things you do in the morning, because that sets the tone to how your day is going to be. And that's exactly what we are going to do now. Let's read a verse here together that you may have read before or not, but this is very important. Let's see what God's word tells us. Anxiety in the heart of a man causes depression, but a good word makes it glad. I want this verse to be kept there on the screen while I speak for a moment. You know, depression is something that it's very difficult to talk about right now, not least because people feel that we shouldn't be putting the word depression and faith in the same sentence, right? People say, oh, when you talk about depression and you talk about faith, somehow people think we are misleading people. But we cannot erase what the Word of God says. I would be a liar, a terrible pastor, and a liar, and a person of no ethics if I don't put the word depression and faith in the same sentence. I wouldn't really believe the Bible if I weren't to do that. And so my faith compels me to put the word depression, anxiety, as you saw there in your screen, and faith in the same sentence, because the Bible talks about this. If our production can leave the verse there for a little bit longer, just for a little bit longer. And the same thing goes for anything else. We could put the word sickness and faith in the same sentence, because faith has the power to override sickness. We could put family problems and faith. We could put addictions and faith. And the truth is, when we speak about anxiety, about depression, or any problem, the Bible, he says that a good word makes the heart glad. Many times we underestimate the power that a word has. And I'm sure that all of us, we've had experiences where we were feeling down about something, we were overwhelmed by a problem, but just with a word that someone told us of something good that was about to happen, or perhaps about our appearance, that we looked good that day, that we looked healthy, something of this nature, that already changed our mind for that day. A word has a power to do that. And not only just words of the Bible, but also words that you have been told by family members. You know, I remember when I was, I probably had just started in my faith, and I remember in my country, when you don't do well at school, you have to repeat the whole year. And that's in primary school, whatever year you're in. And I remember when I was about, I think, 11 or something like that, because my parents were going through a divorce and there was a lot going on at home, I failed that year, that school year. And I had to repeat the whole year again. And when I got home, I felt so terrible, because I thought my mom is going through a terrible time in her life, divorce, financially we were struggling. And it's like I was adding to her worries. So when I got home with the news that I had failed in my exams and I had to redo the whole year again, I broke down. I felt really like a failure. But then my mom, who I think we hadn't even started going to church yet, as a mother, she said, "My son, don't worry. Don't worry. Next year, you'll do better." And those words, that were not necessarily words of faith or of the Word of God, but immediately they changed my day. I'll never forget that day. I went from feeling like the worst son on planet Earth to feeling, actually, this is not the end of the world. We can do better next year. And next year was actually one of the better years that I had at school. And so you see the power of a word. Sometimes someone is walking along, you know, the street, the market, or at work where you are, and the person looks specifically downcast that day. And because you notice the person, you say something to that person that makes their day better, makes the person smile. Look at the power that words have. Imagine the word of God. Are you aware of how powerful the word of God is in your life? God's word has the power to bring hope, to show people that there is a solution for their problems. This is why, after the testimony, you saw there a brief video about the Day of Hope that will be happening on the 25th of August, the last Sunday of August. And when people come to the church, many people ask, "What are you going to give me when I go to your church? Are you going to give me money?" No, we're not going to give you money. But we are going to give you a word that will change your life, that will bring hope that your life can change. This is what has happened to many, to thousands of people who attend the Universal Church here in the UK. And that's exactly what we believe that's going to happen in your life. And who are in the faith, you who are a member of the church, an assistant, Let's use this day to bring the hopeless and the desperate to the church. And now I want to take this opportunity to pray here for the water, to bless the water. If you have the opportunity to do so now, if you're at home, prepare a glass of water. Let's pray for God to bless this water, for God to give you strength today. If you're commuting and you're listening to us on your headphones, perhaps you have a bottle of water in your hands. You can, as you're walking or you're in the bus, in the train, remain in spirit of prayer, with your eyes open, but in spirit of prayer. Let's bless that element, the water, for God to bring strength to you and to your life. All right? Let's unite our faith, because a good word makes the heart glad.
Let's talk to God. It's time to pray.
My Lord, in the name of the Lord Jesus, first of all, I would like to pray for those who wrote their requests on the chat today. We have people who are going to important meetings at work, those who are even trying to do something positive for their community, others who are fighting for situations that are happening in the family. My Lord, I can't remember all of them. There are too many for me to remember. But by faith, I ask you, give this person guidance, my Lord. In some of these cases, people need guidance. And I ask you that you show this person, you guide this person into what they need to say in these meetings, who they need to speak to. Give this person the boldness that is necessary, my Father, for them to take a step of faith. Perhaps this person has been putting off speaking to certain people, doing certain things, but that today will be a day of new things happening. My Lord, I pray now for this person who couldn't sleep last night because they were in so much pain. They were in so much pain that they tossed and turned the whole night and couldn't rest, couldn't sleep. So now, my God, that you may bring relief to this person's body. I pray for this person who struggles with insomnia, that last night when they wouldn't sleep, it will be the last night that they have this problem, and that from today, this person will be at peace when they are, my Lord, in their bed or wherever they sleep. My Father, and for those who need strength, motivation, guidance, when they drink of this water, fill them with this strength. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we declare this water blessed. You can drink of it now. Receive strength. After the prayer you received, remember, don't live by what you feel. Bishop, I feel a certain way. People tell us that a lot. Don't live by what you feel. Live by faith. Go ahead in your faith because God is with you. And now, are you ready for the thought of the day? Let's go for the thought of the day for today, Tuesday.
And now, the thought of the day.
The thought of the day is, can you bring hope with a word of faith to at least one person today? Can you do that? I believe everyone can do that. By the way, let's not misunderstand what a word of faith is. There are people who say that word of faith is to say that something's going to happen. But a word of faith can be to tell someone, look, don't give up. God still has the best days of your life ahead of you. Don't quit. A word of faith can be to show a person that it is possible to overcome their problems. Choose one person to do that today. Not yourself, okay? Don't look in the mirror and point the finger and because you've already received strength. but someone in your family, someone at work, someone from church or who stopped going to church and who's been discouraged. And what better way to give that person a word of faith than to invite them for the day of hope? Choose one person at least to do that today. I believe we all can do that. We'll see you back here on Be Inspired tomorrow at 7:30 at the same time. May God bless you. Bye-bye. It's so light.